Hello, and welcome to Managing Serial Numbers for Individual macOS Virtual Machines. My name is Spike Burton, and I'm a senior software developer at MacStadium, where I work on Orka, which is our homegrown solution for virtualizing and orchestrating macOS using Kubernetes on authentic Apple hardware. So we're going to talk a little bit about serial numbers. As I'm sure most of you are very well aware, the serial number for a Mac computer is available by going to the Apple menu and clicking on About This Mac. It's listed at the very bottom of the system information, and it's a 12 to 15 character alphanumeric sequence, as it's circled above in red here. So first of all, why do we care? Well, as an Apple administrator, you're often doing things like interacting with Apple Business Manager, making use of Apple's device enrollment program, and integrating with a mobile device management platform like Jamf or Jamf Pro. And the serial number is kind of the important piece of information that makes this all work behind the scenes. It's what's used to verify the device. So why virtualization? In the context of needing an Apple desktop, whether this is for a lab environment or a training course of some sort, setting up and tearing down bare metal is time-consuming and labor-intensive. The machines have to be charged and wiped clean in between each use, and spinning up and tearing down virtual machines is a process that can be automated. Virtual machines can easily be provisioned with a standard starting configuration in a reproducible way, and there's no need to set up, reset, or reconfigure hardware or software in between each use. So with authentic Apple hardware, it's enrolled and managed via the serial number, but this is more of an implementation detail that we need not worry ourselves with. That all happens behind the scenes. Virtualized macOS is a little bit different story. macOS has no concept of what an authentic serial number is, quote unquote. But in this scenario, what we can do is the serial number can be presented to macOS via the system management BIOS or SMBIOS. This is what provides management information to the operating system that's available from the system firmware. And in the context of a virtual machine, SMBIOS is emulated and the serial number can be injected. So I'd like to talk a little bit about a case study for the Jamf Nation User Conference last year, 2020. It was held virtually, as I'm sure most of you or all of you are well aware, due to the pandemic. And the interactive labs were actually powered by Orka. A little bit more information can be found by going to macstadium.com/customers/Jamf if you're curious to read. A little bit about us, who we are. MacStadium is the leading provider of Mac infrastructure as a service. This includes VMware, Anka, our own solution, Orka, as well as Bare Metal. We have data centers worldwide, which host genuine Apple hardware. And we offer enterprise-grade private clouds with top-grade storage, networking, and security solutions. So this includes Cisco and Palo Alto firewalls, Cisco switches, as well as pure storage flash blades. I mentioned Orka a little bit. Orka is an acronym for orchestration with Kubernetes on Apple. So as I mentioned previously, this is our own solution for virtualizing and orchestrating macOS. We leverage Kubernetes for this. A little more information can be found at macstadium.com/Orka, but I've got an architectural diagram here on the right-hand side, which is a little bit more of a visual aid here. So basically what we do is we take a group of Mac hosts, we turn that into a Kubernetes cluster, which is connected to a storage area network for data sharing. On each physical host, we put a hypervisor, and then we use Kubernetes to orchestrate containers in the cluster. And inside of each container, we stuff a full-blown macOS VM. So for JNUC 2020, as I mentioned before, the conference was held virtually due to the COVID-19 pandemic, and we needed a solution to provide virtual attendees with an opportunity for hands-on experience with Jamf. So MacStadium actually partnered with Jamf to provide Mac infrastructure for the interactive labs, and those interactive labs use virtual Mac remote desktops, which were powered by Orka. So the technical challenge here, right, is how do we enroll a virtual machine with Apple device enrollment and integrate it with something like Jamf? the Jamf team essentially needed to assign an owned serial number to each virtual machine. So what this means is that a physical piece of hardware that was owned by the company, we took that serial number and injected that into the virtual machine. Those virtual machines could then be enrolled in Jamf device management. And in order to accomplish this, we on the Orka team created a custom Docker image using a serial number, which Jamf provided. Each virtual machine deployed in the Kubernetes cluster then used this custom Docker image. And just kind of as a review of the overall architecture here with Orka, each macOS VM is actually housed inside of a container. And so what we were able to do was add to the container image that serial number, which was able to be used by the macOS VM. So this solution provided a one-to-many relationship between the serial number and the virtual machines. In other words, that same custom serial number was used for every virtual machine which was deployed in the cluster. Overall, the JNUC 2020 Interactive Labs were a huge success for Jamf and for us as well. Afterwards, another team at Jamf approached us with a similar need for putting on training courses using remote macOS desktops. For this, the Orka team, we worked with Jamf again to provide them a custom Docker image with a serial number that they provided us, which was very similar to the setup that they had for JNUC last year. So there was a little bit room for improvement here. The Jamf team actually needed to assign a unique serial number to each virtual machine, and they needed to be able to assign that at the time of deployment. So what we did on the Orka team was we actually took this request and developed it into a full-blown feature, which we released in Orka 1.6, which is now widely available to all Orka customers. To learn a little bit more about this, please feel free to visit orkadocs.macstadium.com/docs/bring-your-own-macOS-serial-number, which goes a little bit more into depth about how the feature works, how it's available to you, and what you're able to do with it. So thanks for listening. I hope you found this talk to be informative and interesting, and I hope that you enjoy the rest of the JNUC conference this year.